Hey, what's my yo? Happy February. So I decided that for the entire month of February, I would only be covering love-related topics. All of the topics of this month have all been requested or they're frequently asked questions, so I thought, why not take all of those topics, throw them all together for February. After this month, I will be getting back to health and spiritual topics, and this year in general, I will be working on as many of the topic requests that I've been getting as possible. I'm gonna try and work through as many of them as I can. You'll just have to be patient because I only upload one video a week. But for now, I thought we would have some fun talking about love in February. Today's topic is the struggles of dating while chronically ill. I did do a blog post on this topic a while back, but essentially, dating while you're chronically ill or dealing with any kind of large health or mental health problem for that matter is all really difficult. Personally, I did try online dating back in my teen years. I was too young for a lot of them, but I was able to use chatting apps, and primarily I was using them to try and find friends. Unfortunately, I quickly learned that sharing about my life, sharing about my health, shut down conversations quicker than literally anything. I would tell people about my health situation and would usually get a few short follow-up questions, a shallow, "I'm so sorry," and then the conversation would end abruptly. People would leave me on read, and that means that people would open my message, they would see it, and they would choose not to answer me ever again. Through my time on chatting apps as a teenager, I made one friend, one very great friend, and I'm thankful for that. But it was mostly failure. Friendship alone, or really any kind of relationship, is honestly very, very hard when you're chronically ill. Quite frankly, you don't have the energy for relationships. Your life is so consumed by dealing with your health, or you're so tired from your health, that you don't have anything to give to a relationship. The small bits of energy you do have, you spend to brush your hair, to get clothed, to use the bathroom, to take a shower, to feed yourself, and to put yourself back in bed. And you don't have the energy for anyone else but just taking care of you. You really don't even have the energy to fully take care of yourself, let alone handle another person being in your life. Honestly, it's really hard too to find people, I mean, romantic or not, just to find people who can look past all of the complications and struggles of your health and still see you on the inside as a person. Past the point that I became sick, I had a really hard time making friends, so it didn't really surprise me that I also struggled to find love. I had a few that almost maybe went somewhere, but really everything always ended the same. People left. People couldn't handle my health situation, they couldn't look past it and see the person I am on the inside. It was too much. They obviously thought maybe my situation was just too hard and too daunting. And so they left, and I was always ghosted. People also had this tendency to never say goodbye either, or never give me an explanation. People always just left, and I always had to find closure on my own. Last year, I shared a video on my channel of me proposing to my longtime boyfriend, and after that video, I received more questions or more comments and some video requests to cover this topic, because obviously I had been through a lot in my life, and yet somehow I still found love. Technically though, honestly, my fiance and I actually met because of a friend setting us up together, and at the time, neither of us were actually looking for love, we just happened to click. And it just worked out. But just because we've clicked really easily and we have a really great relationship doesn't mean that it's always been easy. It's been really hard, but we work really hard together. It's been quite a journey together, and now, a year from now, we'll be getting married. So even if you do find the right person and you do click and the relationship itself is easy, that doesn't mean that everything else going on involving your health is also still easy. Relationships are still really hard when you're chronically ill, or even if you're in remission, relationships are just hard. Justin and I were not able to date normally because shortly after we met, my health started to decline, and then a year after we met and had been together, my health really, really took a turn for the worst. So most of our dating, our early dating, was just spent here at my parents' house. We would be in our pajamas watching movies, talking, laughing, getting to know each other deeply as people and as souls, and spending simple, great quality time together rather than doing a bunch of fun things together. Our relationship was different right away from the start. Even into remission, most of our time together is just quality time at home spent with our fur babies. There's a lot of layers of why relationships are so hard when you're chronically ill, but for me, I think definitely one of the most frustrating and difficult parts of having relationships while you're chronically ill is when it comes to those points that your health takes a dip, or you have a health flare or a mental health flare, and suddenly, without much warning, you don't have the energy for a relationship anymore. If you hadn't been with that person, you would not choose to start a relationship while you're in that kind of place. But you're in the relationship when it happens, and suddenly you just don't have the energy to have a relationship, and it gets really hard. For example, plans will get canceled last minute, and then either you're alone at home feeling bummed that you couldn't go, or your person cancels their plans and their normal life and comes to you and takes care of you. You can so easily feel like a burden, or like dead weight, or like you're holding them back, or like you're their patient and they're your caretaker. I often felt guilty, I felt apologetic. I even at times encouraged him to leave me and said it was okay, he should go be normal. Obviously that's not who he is, and that's not ever how he felt about me or my health stuff. That was just me and my own insecurities and my own wounds from my past failed friendships and almost relationships. That's, I guess, another obstacle you face when trying to form a healthy relationship while you're dealing with all of this, is inevitably you have a lot of those failed attempts and you get wounds from it, and then that can carry over to your actually healthy relationship. I could talk so much more about our relationship and all of the ups and downs and challenges we've faced together over the years, but really, that would be its whole own story. And point being, though, the reason I share a little bit about us is that I did find someone who loves me for me, and that he even loved me more because of all of the things I had been through, rather than all of the other people who one look at my life and they ran for the hills. I guess if I had any advice for how to maybe approach dating while chronically ill, or approach relationships while chronically ill, the two biggest and best points I would encourage are to be yourself and to be honest. Be yourself, because although your health takes up so much of your time, your energy, your thoughts, everything, you are so much more than your health. You are the person inside, you are your sense of humor, you're the things that you love, the things that bring you passion and all of that. The right people, romantic or not, will see all of you and will love all of you. They won't just see your illness, they'll see all of you and they will love all of it, and they'll just be proud for the fighter that you are. Be honest, because sure, you can fake it till you make it as much as you want, but eventually at the end of the day, the truth always comes out. And in that time of trying to hold things back and hide things, it's really just tiring for you. Personally, I tried a lot of different angles to how do I tell people about what my life is? Maybe if I tried a different way, it'll work. But what I found is that it's much less tiring for me to just be honest right from the start. To go around trying to hide everything that my life is and everything that I'm going through is fucking exhausting. And really, it just delays the inevitable of that if people can't handle it and they don't like what my life is and they don't like the realities that I deal with, they don't know how to handle it. It's better to know sooner rather than later if that's the case. If people are the types of people who are gonna run for the hills at the first moment that I tell them what my life is, I would rather know right away, rather than sit around and 6 months into knowing someone, eventually they find out the full reality of my life and they leave and I'm crushed. There's a lot of reasons I prefer to lead with honesty, but really that's the biggest part of it, is I would rather know sooner rather than later if someone can handle my situation or not. for anyone really, and in so many different situations, I'm just in general a very big cheerleader of being yourself and being honest, because why waste your life trying to be something else or trying to hide who you are? You would rather have people around you who know who you are and love who you are, rather than hiding and wondering if maybe they'll reject you later on. I really believe honesty and being yourself will take you so much further in life, just across the board, and will gain you far deeper and more authentic connections than any other alternative. Personally, I was looking for true friends and genuine love, and if it's not true and deep and genuine and authentic, I don't want it. I'm not interested. I would rather have quality over quantity. I would rather be alone than be surrounded by people who don't actually care. But that's me, and that is my preference. So obviously my advice and my input would be angled towards that. It would be towards finding truer, deeper, more authentic connections and people who love all of you rather than just bits and pieces that are convenient to them. But if you yourself are looking for lighter connections, then you absolutely could go about things completely differently. But someone else's input may benefit you more on that. I would also encourage, be sure to prioritize your health. No matter who you're with or what you're doing, your health should be your number one, even if it's hard. Don't be with people who freaking guilt you for what your life is and what your health is, because that's just BS and unhelpful. You don't need to be around someone who's guilting you for having to choose your health over them. You're choosing to try and live. Crazy. If who you're with, whether this is a family, friend, platonic, romantic partner, whoever it may be, if they are unhelpful and unsupportive and they're not a healing presence in your life, then I really encourage you to reevaluate and uphold your boundaries more, because you deserve that and you deserve to have that healing space of supportive people. Healthy relationships only, my friends. Healthy relationships only. When you are healing and you're fighting for your life, you don't have the freaking room in your life to have crappy, wishy-washy, You only have space for healthy relationships. Healthy, happy, and mutually loving relationships. That's what we're here for. That is today's video, and be sure to stick around for the rest of February to hear my other love-related topics that have been requested over the years. If you have any other types of video requests, you can always leave it in the comments below. If you have any questions relating to this topic, or if you want to eventually hear more about my own relationship stuff, you can ask questions and I'll answer it, or maybe I'll turn it into a video. Always, you can leave stuff in the comments below. Be sure to give this video a like if you liked it, and subscribe to my channel if you want to come back for more. There are lots of playlists on my channel that you can check out. They are all organized and categorized because your girl is OCD as hell. Thank you for coming to my corner of the internet and spending some time with me today. I appreciate you, my lovely friend. I wish you nothing but love and goodness for this beautiful month of February. Ding!
Classic mayo.
I'm just a... Hey. No. No. No barks.